Now we are going to get a first impression of visualizations, and I will connect that to this specific topic, namely procurement analytics. So we will talk about procurement KPIs, and we will look at corresponding dashboards in the end, and we will also look at a data warehouse, especially as at a specific procurement data mart that could be the basis for the dashboards. Yeah. So before starting, maybe during the MBA program, you might have already encountered some KPIs from procurement, or you might already know them from your former work. Yeah, so what do you have you any knowledge about KPIs within procurement?
We could consider turnaround time, like how much time does it take? Then order to pay cycle, how much time does it take with that?
Yeah, for example.
Then
Other ones specifically concerned with procurement analytics? Lead time, yeah, for example. That's a common thing. Any further ideas? Okay, so then let's look at some. So here is a bunch, an assortment of KPIs that you might encounter. Yeah, for example, compliance rate, supplier defect rate, lead time we already have had, purchase order cycle times we have already had that, supplier availability, cost per invoice and per purchase order, rate of emergency purchases, spend under management, price competitiveness, yeah, and so on and so on. So there are a lot of different KPIs available. Actually, next week I will have a colloquium on a master thesis for one of your colleagues from a former semester that has built up here purchase KPIs and performance dashboard, yeah, for a Berlin-based small company. Okay, so let's for example talk about compliance rate. So I'm talking a little bit about the meaning of the KPIs, yeah, and then we will look at visualizations, yeah. So for example, compliance rate could mean different things. For example, ratio of disputed invoices to total invoices, or ratio of deliveries in time to all deliveries, or difference between price paid and price quoted. Yeah. Difference between contracted reaction time and actual reaction times. Yeah. Ratio of service delivered outside service level agreements. Yeah. To total service delivered. Yeah. Or ratio of notice deliveries with respect to all deliveries. Yeah, so all kind of deviations from planned figures, yeah, might be regarded within compliance, yeah, right. So for example, here we have a dashboard, yeah, so that we could that how compliance rate could be visualized, yeah. And so please remember that compliance rate first and of all is a number, yeah. So as I have defined it before, actually it's a percent value, yeah, some kind of percentage, yeah, because it's a ratio, yeah. And having our multidimensional model in mind, we also might have dimensions. Yeah, so let's take a look at this dashboard and let's try to connect it a little bit to one hypothetical data warehouse on which that on top of which it sits. Yeah, so 68% overall compliance rate, that is just the number, yeah, without regarding any specific dimension. So that's overall with respect to all dimensions. Yeah, so we have a compliance rate, whatever compliance now means, yeah, that is not depicted here. Let's say ratio of disputed invoices to total invoices. Yeah, so if we take all our invoices, and let's assume it's let's assume of last year or so, yeah, or even let's assume any time, so all invoices that we have had, yeah, and 68% were okay, but the other 32% were not okay. Yeah, so if we look here at the bar chart, what do you think? So it's telling us software that the compliance rate was 75% and digital service only were 9%. Yeah, so okay, yeah, that is something that doesn't make sense. Disputed invoices, yeah, yeah, that is something that for example for services disputed invoices might occur much more often. Yeah, what do you think, which dimension has been used here, or which dimension would be able to support that visualization?
Software.
The software is a specific element within that dimension, but about which? So regarding our my slides, yeah, there I've mentioned several dimensions. What do you think? Which dimension is it here? And which level?
Do you mean like a two-dimensional bar graph?
I just want to know the name of what. So yeah, is it a time dimension? No. Is it geography dimension? No. Which dimension is it? Product, that's the product dimension. And which level? Let's assume it's product category or something like that. Yeah? Got it? There we have used the product dimension. So if we look at this chart here below. Which dimension?
Time dimension.
Time, that's obvious. Yeah, so the time dimension has been used here. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is an important thing that we are able to do visualizations, of course, but we also have to get a feeling what is the underlying data that we are relying on. Yeah, so supplier defect rate, ratio of substandard products to total number of products tested. Yeah. And so here we have a supplier defect rate dashboard, yeah. So of course we would have here the vendor or supplier dimension, yeah. That would be would have been used here. And here we have something that's called defect type. Yeah, so the defect type, let's see, rejected impact, no impact, yeah. So if you look at this kind of thing here, yeah, you might recognize that we might have a defect type dimension that has three values, rejected, impact, and no impact, whatever that means here, yeah. You see this stacked bar chart here that could be used to there we could use the defect type, yeah, in order to to provide this visualization. Yeah. So for example, we have an overall defect type here for supplier one of 1%, and 1%, and then 80% of them have no impact, and but 5% had an impact, and so on. Yeah, whatever. I do not know what impact means here. In that case, do you have any idea what impact could mean here? What might that mean? Maybe impact for the production process or something like that. I'm not sure. Yeah. But that's not the problem here. So let's take a look at supplier lead time. Yeah, could mean, for example, difference between shipping time and order time. Yeah, after purchase order acceptance. So the vendor, the supplier has accepted the purchase order, and until when it is shipped, or if it is between your own company, yeah, if you get the order until you ship, or difference between delivery time and order time, yeah, so that could be different things. And also here we could, is it supplier lead time? Supplier lead time, yeah. Also here we have, for example, an average lead time, and then the lead time, the development, the lead time over the year 2017. And then we have here some outliers, for example, that might be marked specifically, and so on. Yeah. Purchase order cycle time, difference between requisition time and order submission time to supplier, yeah, or difference between delivery time from supplier and payment time to supplier, yeah. So that could be, so purchase order cycle time. Also here we have, for example, the number of suppliers, yeah, and then we have defined categories like short, medium, and long, yeah. So what do you think these categories, short, medium, long, where do they come from? That would also would be something, for example, within the purchase department that has to be discussed. Yeah, what does short mean? Yeah, for our company. Yeah, is it 1 day or 2 days, and medium and long? Yeah, so you would define that's also some could be a kind of dimension, and you would define it. Yeah, and with respect to the discussion of conformed dimension, yeah, that might be something that different people have different opinions on. So within the conformed dimension development, you have to agree on a specific value. Yeah. Okay. Number of suppliers. Yeah. That would be the typical counting of things. Yeah. And also here we have development of average purchase or the cycle time. Yeah. Over time. Yeah. We have the time dimension again in it. Yeah. In this dashboard, for example, we don't have used the product dimension. It's not used here, yeah. But the supplier dimension, must have been used. Otherwise, the supplier dimension is also not used. Sorry, because it's just about how long it takes, yeah. So and so on. What do we have? Ratio of number of blah blah blah. Yeah, I'm not going into detail over all these dashboards here, yeah, but I think you get an impression what the dashboards are about, yeah. Cost of purchase order, yeah. So often you have such elements that you have so an overall information item here, yeah, one singular value, and then you have a trend, some kind of trend, and some bar charts, yeah, in order to compare things, and so on. Emergency rate, yeah. Spent under management. So for some of the KPIs, I don't have found any So I've taken these ones, I've taken just from the internet here. Yeah. From let's see, what was it here? From from Datapine, yeah. Datapine is a visualization tool that could be used for that. I've taken from their website, yeah. And for some they don't have an example available. Yeah. Okay, yeah. So if you talk about visualizations, we talk about visual elements, for example, line charts, bar charts. What else do we have? Stacked bar charts, such kind of, I'm not sure how they are called. Pie charts could be, for example, yeah, bubble charts, tree charts, heat maps. So that's all we are going to encounter later on when using Tableau. And what you also see is, for example, if I take this one here, yeah, so this is consists of three elements, this dashboard, this here, then the bar chart here, and so a bullet item list, a bar chart, and a line chart. Yeah. Okay, before going ahead in building such kind of dashboards, I would like to discuss a little bit how a procurement data mart could be the basis for such kinds of dashboards. So do you remember what a data mart is? A data mart is just a subset of a data warehouse and usually devoted to a specific department. Yeah. So we might, for example, have a procurement data mart, yeah, a finance data mart, a production data mart, and so on. Yeah. In practice, often you have those data marts, but not unifying data warehouse. Yeah. But the best, the ideal word would be you would have a single point of truth, as it is called, yeah, the data warehouse, and you derive from them the data marts. Yeah, that would be the best thing. But in practice, often you have separate, disparate marts. Yeah, and let's assume we have a procurement data mart here. So in consolidated integrated data store for procurement data, that could be that could serve as a base for the KPI calculation. Yeah. Such kind of procurement data mart is something that's not easy to construct, I can tell you. Yeah. Because many source systems have to be considered. Yeah. So if you look at all these KPIs, yeah, that I have mentioned here. Yeah. So let's go back here. Yeah. If you look at it, you can imagine that for all these different things, compliance rate, spend under management, emergency purchases, you need different data sources where you get that information from. Yeah. Different systems that's not available with one, within one singular database, for example, yeah. Usually you need a lot of different data sources, and the data and the different data sources might not be easily to integrate, yeah. So a procurement data mart actually is some kind of heavy activity, heavy initiative, yeah. That have to be carried out. So, for example, the master thesis I've talked about before, yeah, that was actually within a company that don't has anything that like that yet. So they are going into the direction of building a procurement data mart, yeah, and they encounter all this problem. Okay, so let's talk about source systems. Yeah, for example, the order management system, the warehouse management system, so warehouse, the physical warehouse here, a quality assurance system might be used, the accounts payable, contract management marketing intelligence sites, yeah, all this kind of stuff might be used, yeah, in order to build the procurement data mart. What kind of dimensions we might encounter? Of course, the supplier dimension, the purchase order dimension, the date, time dimension, different roles, geography, of course, product, contract term dimension, defect kind dimension, defect kind impact dimension, cycle duration kind, purchase kind, yeah. All these things might be defined, yeah. Might need to be defined. And then, for example, let's talk about KPIs for defects. Yeah. So a defect table. Yeah. That might have the following dimensions. So the order dimension, the product dimension, the supplier dimension, the defect kind dimension, a date dimension, and the defect impact kind dimension. Yeah. And what would be the measurement, the measure within that fact table? Actually, none. That seems surprising, doesn't it? Since the fact table here just tells you that one defect happens with these characteristics. And such kind of tables where you just the fact is just the occurrence of a specific event without revenue or profit or something like that, but just that it happened. Such tables occur quite often in data warehouses, and they are called factless fact table. Yeah, so sounds like a contradiction. Yeah, but factless fact table is a term within data warehouse area. Yeah, and nevertheless, you can do a lot with that. You can count, and for example, you can compare it with all other events. Yeah, you can count it, and then you can, for example, if you have the date dimension, you can count it, how many were last month and how many are this month, and counting that in that way, you can provide a line chart as we have seen before in the dashboards. Yeah, so that's so dealing with defects and quality and so on, yeah, in the procurement kind of thing, we could design such kind of factless fact table for defect facts. Yeah, of course we also have all the other fact tables. We have already seen some. Yeah, this purchase requisition fact table and all other kinds of fact tables could be there. Yeah, and if you look at the list of dimension, yeah, you already see the complexity of the stuff here. Yeah. Okay, so that was to give you an impression, and now to take a step towards visualization. Yeah. So, and what I would like to do now is you are not going to start using Tableau yet. Yeah. I just want you to show the general proceeding, how a dashboard could be constructed, yeah. And so just an overview is just for you to motivate you and to give you an idea what all of that we are going to do next week is about, yeah. And all the details and how to use Tableau, that is something that we will do together next week, yeah, and where you also do exercises and work on your own. Yeah, but for now, I just wanted to give you an idea about that, and I'm not going to explain everything in detail so that you can follow on. Just look at it and yeah, enjoy. Hopefully. So, what I am now going to do is so there is here's a database that is for orders. Yeah, so we have all this dimension, the customer dimension, the product dimension, and so on, that's available here now. Yeah, and what I would now like to do is to build a dashboard. Yeah, for sales orders, in order to analyze sales orders. And first of all, I'm going to start with the following. I will build a visualization that shows us the sales per product category. Yeah, so I'm going to use product categories. Yeah, I'm going to use sales. Yeah, and I'm going to create a bar chart on that, and I will do it. I will turn it into a vertically or a horizontal, vertical bar chart. Yeah, and I call it just rename here. Let's say sales by, what was this category? Sales by cut. Yeah, so this is one bar chart now. Sales by category. The next thing I'm going to do is I will show you sales by year. So second sheet, as it is called in Tableau. Yeah, so I take the year, I also take sales. Yeah, again bar chart again. So now we have sales by year, so that's sales by year now, the second bar chart, second sheet. Yeah, the third one is sales by state. So I'm going into geography dimension, it's location here it's called. Yeah, I take the state, and you see Tableau out of the box provides maps. I take sales, I put them on the label, and I take sales and coloring these things. Yeah. And last but not least, I would like to get an let's call it let's rename it sales by state. Yeah, and now I'm just as we have seen in the procurement dashboard, sometimes you only want to have an overall number. Yeah, so let's provide a sheet. Let's call it so the sheet, I just put in the sales value. Yeah, so that's the overall all sales here. Yeah, let's call it here. Let's call it overall. Yeah, oops. So let's call it overall, and let's rename the sheet here. All or something like that. Yeah. Okay. Now we have four sheets: sales by cut, sales by year, sales by state, and this all kind of thing. Yeah. And now I'm constructing a dashboard. So that's the way how to construct a dashboard. And you see on the left hand side, I can use the different sheets here. Yeah, so let's start by state. I drag it here into. Yeah, and we have here this coloring here. Let's remove that because I don't want to see it here. Yeah, then let's take the sales by category. Yeah, and let's take the sales by year. Yeah, so now you see we have three different visualizations here, and let's add all again here. Let's put it here. Let's see if it, now let's put it so that way. Yeah, so that we have overall here, and let's rearrange it a little bit. Yeah, And let's make it a little bit smaller here, yeah. So so now that's a dashboard. We see, for example, here the sales by state. We see the sales by year and the sales by cut. And one nice thing that Tableau provides is the following. I can, if I click here on this, yeah, I can here build in or can activate filters, as it's called. Yeah, I activate the filter here, yeah. And I activate that's the filter here. And now please look at the map. So let's take here a look at California, yeah. 57, sorry, and something as sales, yeah. And now I click on technology, and you see it. It is here now filtered according to technology, yeah. And then I take, for example, 2018, yeah. And now I see, you see all the values here. Are now adjusted to that filtering, yeah, and that's what dashboards are good for, yeah. You see, you can select things here, you can filter things, yeah, directly, yeah, that's possible to do here, yeah, quite easily. So and you see some empty spaces here. That means that there is no record in it, no fact. So, for example, I don't know which state that is here. Yeah, let's see what it is. Let's click on that, and so that here was Wyoming, yeah. And if I take 2018 and technology, so that Wyoming, no technology has been sold. Yeah. Okay. One thing that's a little bit unfortunate, if you look at this overall here, yeah. You see it is also adjusting here, but we would like to keep it fixed. Yeah, we would like to see, because the other values are already here if I take this one here, yeah, you see that's because they are also in here, because both are filters here, yeah. We see here the same filtering, yeah, and we would like to see the overall value here, yeah. So besides providing simple visualization that could be connected by each other and so on, yeah, Tableau provides also some kind of calculation engine, yeah, that allows you to handle such kind of things here. And in this case, it's quite a simple calculation that we are going to use. So I go back here, I provide a new sheet, yeah, I do the following. First of all, I'm creating a so-called calculated field, yeah. That's a calculated field, and I call it overall, yeah. And this calculated field, I insert a formula in the language the Tableau provides, yeah. That is it's a level of detail expression, LOD. That's the way how it is called, yeah. So I have fixed sum of sales, yeah. And you see now I got a calculated measure. It's called overall, yeah. And if I take overall here and put it here in, we see it has the same value as our all. Oh, here it's filtered. We immediately see it, yeah, since it's not filtered. And if we let's call it let's call it all one, yeah, and let's go to the dashboard, yeah, and remove this one here and put in all one, yeah, and let's filter again. You see it stays fixed.